Hello and welcome to pdfsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an Allen Bradley PLC-5 processor. I have here an L540E. 540E because it has Ethernet capability, which is something else that we'll be testing. And it's being powered by a 1771 P4S power supply. And the rack I'm using is a 1771 A1B 4-slot chassis, which is otherwise empty because this test is simply on the processor, not anything else. I'm connected to it using an RS-232 through channel 0 for this test. So the first thing I'm going to do is make my communication path between the computer and the processor. I'm going to do that by opening up RS Links Classic Lite. And once that's open, I'm going to go to Configure Drivers, which is this squiggly line with a connection at each end icon. Click on that, and if you don't already have a driver in your Configure Drivers drop-down, then now would be the appropriate time to select one. Again, I've selected the RS-232 default 1 Allen Bradley device. So once that's in your Configure Drivers menu, you can go to Configure. This is the button on your right. And a third window will pop open now. And this is what we call the cheat button. This is the actually creates the connection between the computer. So I'm going to hit Auto Configure. Now, the important thing to remember is under COM port on the top left-hand side, just make sure that you're using the appropriate COM port, or you've selected the appropriate COM port for what you're using at the other end of this cable. All the other stuff, when you hit Auto Configure, we call it the cheat button, will auto employ. So baud rate, parity, stop bits, if any of those things are different, this system will change it for you. I'm going to select OK once it's configured and running. We're going to close out the Configure Drivers menu, and we're going to reduce RS Links Classic Lite, but we're going to keep it running. Now I'm going to open up RS Logix 5 software, go to File, New, and it's going to ask us, a window is going to pop open asking us to select the processor type. So the platform is going to be Ethernet. You want to change that to Ethernet in the drop-down. In this particular case, it's a PLC-540E for Ethernet. And we're going to hit OK. If you happen to know the series and the revision, the firmware revision on the side of the module, on the side of the processor, you can go ahead and put that in under series and revision. If you don't know it, it's OK because the RS Logix 5 will figure it out for you. So now I've got a new file, an unnamed, untitled file. And the first thing I want to do is go to Channel Configuration, double-click on that, or right-click. Go to Channel 2 on your far right tab. And then this is my Ethernet configuration. So under Network Configuration Type, this is the left-hand side, almost halfway down. Well, I'm going to select Static. Network Configuration Type is Static. And that'll allow me to create an IP address. What I would recommend is making an IP address that doesn't conflict with anything else that you have on the network. Is a number that's perhaps far beyond anything else that's on the network, so you don't ping or conflict with anything else that's going on. Once you have the IP address and the subnet mask sorted out, hit Apply, which is the button on the bottom right hand side. And then that button will turn gray, and you want to hit OK. So now would be a good time to tell you that this processor I have here has a battery that's been tested good. I say this particularly on the Ethernet modules. Of course, you should always have a good tested battery in these processors. But in the instance that you remove the processor and you're testing it solely, if you've configured an IP address, sometimes you need to power cycle in order for that IP address to take. So that would be it would be good to have a battery that's in good working order, or actually a must. So just make sure that that's working properly. Okay, the next thing is, once that's configured, we're going to go do a download. Go to the top left hand side where a white box says offline and hit the drop down menu and it gives you choices, go online, online now, download. We're going to select download. Now, this is the part where as it's going through the download, it's going to check to make sure that everything is correct, as I was describing before. So this is chosen to correct me on the revision in the series. I'm going to go ahead and say okay, because it can see what it really is, and I may have not have checked it before I put it in the slot. And it's also asking me that there is a difference in the IP address. Am I sure that I want to change it in order to test it? In my particular case, yes. If you already have an IP address that it's working at, you can go ahead and keep that. All right, so I'm going to say okay. Now the downloading process or image screen is going to pop open as it finishes the download. Okay, the next thing that's going to come up is the whether you want to title this file. I usually just put in the name of the processor, L540E test, and hit OK or save. Do you want to go online? Yes. So now that I'm online, where it used to say offline on the top left-hand side of my screen, it now says program. So naturally, what I'm going to do is turn this to remote program, hard run, back to remote run. For a test, you don't necessarily need the hard run, but you want to go all the way through and back to make sure that on your computer screen, on your software, it shows that you're green and in run mode and not faulted. So remote run is what I normally use to test this processor. Well, a couple things. Before we get to the Ethernet, we want to check the processor status. So on the left-hand side, you can either right-click on processor status and hit open, or double-click on it. And this, it'll say file S2 status. It's got a bunch of different tabs. It's a window that pops open with tabs at the top. And the one I'm going to go to on as you're going to the right-hand side is errors. This is going to show me if there's any current errors with the processor. So again, if this is a troubled processor, this would be a good place to start to see if there's any problems, what they are, what the codes are. If it seems like it's the description is something minor, and it's something that I understand what it is, I would probably hit clear major error. And clear that out, and then you might want to go through processor warning, which is the next tab, program warning, channel warning, and so on, just to take a look that everything's in the condition it should be in. So once that's done, it's okay to go ahead and test the Ethernet side. So what you're going to need is a transceiver. Okay, this plugs into the front in channel 2, and the other side is for the Ethernet plug. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and put this on securely. It's not moving. And plug in, I have a local Ethernet cable that's on our network. And if you folks can see right above channel 2, I have a status of a green light. That's what you want to see before you ping it. So I'm going to go to my command prompt on the computer in the start menu, and I'm going to hit ping and the address that I've chosen. Okay, so what I'm looking for is I'm looking for a reply. When I ping it at the address that we've chosen for it, I want to make sure that there's a reply. There's usually 4 replies when you ping it. If, for any reason, it doesn't reply, then there may be a problem with the Ethernet card. And the other thing that I usually do is, just to make sure I'm not pinging another device and getting a false sense of security, I'll unplug this Ethernet and or the transceiver. and I'm going to go ahead and ping it again. So if I've gotten a successful ping and it replied, then the second time around without it, I shouldn't get a reply. What I'm doing here is I'm just testing to make sure that I'm not pinging another device that's been set up on my network that I don't know about. Okay, so now that I do that, and I have no response at all. So that test is good. So that's generally what we do to test these processors if we feel it's troubled. Make sure that it can go into run mode. Another thing that you would want to do is to leave this processor in run mode for a day, a couple days, maybe over a weekend, 2 or 3 days. And what you want to do is try to see if you can make it kick itself out of run mode. Perhaps put I/O modules to the right to fill up the rack. You can cover the bottom with plastic, the top with plastic, so that heat has difficulty escaping and it puts the processor under a little bit more strain just to test its durability. So if it fails, then you could always go to the processor status and find out what the errors are and see if it's something that you're able to figure out yourself. If it doesn't fail and it stays in run mode, we feel that it's a good working processor. So again, if it's something that you feel that you can't fix and it's definitely a troubled processor, this is something that we do repair here at PDF Supply. We have new and remanufactured products and exchange programs and same day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.